In 2022, during the UK leg of the Cure Tour, we took a little detour in between the gigs to check out another cool part of Cure history.
Oh, can we go this way? How many acres did she say that this land?
33,000.
What?
Yeah.
33,000 acres?
Yeah.
It's always an adventure to be found.
In 1981, Robert Smith asked teenage art student Andy Vella if he would design the cover of Faith. Andy got right on it with his parched art collaborator, Pearl.
The question behind the question is, I'm not sure why this was chosen for an album cover. Bolton Abbey Missing Stepstones. This is about, how far would you say we are from Leeds? Maybe an hour north? Bolton Abbey, which is the cover of the Faith album. Here it is.
I can't tell you why Parched Art chose Bolton Abbey. What I can do is tell you about the process of writing Faith, according to the book, 10 Imaginary Years. It says, between 2nd and 11th of February, 1981, The Cure went into Morgan Studios to record their next album, Faith, a torturous process, which eventually consumed the whole month. The band went from Redbus to the Roadhouse to Trident and to Abbey Road in a bid to capture what Robert was after. In an interview with Robert Smith for Record Mirror, he says, I've always tried to make records that are of one piece, that explain a certain kind of atmosphere to its fullest. That's why I always liked Nick Drake albums or Plink Forward records like Umaguma. I like a lot of music built around repetitions, Benedictine chants particularly, and Indian mantras. These musics are built around slow changes. They allow you to draw things out. Back to 10 Imaginary Years, Robert says, quote, Lowell's mother became very ill at this time, and Lowell and I used to talk about death a lot, about how easy it is to turn it into something abstract until it turns up on your doorstep.
You know, I have to say, being here at the last part of this tour is pretty intense in more ways than one.
I used to go and write songs in church. I'd think about death, and I'd look at the people in the church. All of a sudden, I realized I had no faith at all, and I was scared. I wanted to get at different expressions of faith, to understand why people have it, to see if it was a real thing. I asked myself questions about people around me, why they were doing what they were doing, why some of them devoted their whole lives to something they would only get after death. I immersed myself in it and found it stupid, and Faith became a difficult album to make. We just couldn't get the songs to sound right. We just kept doing them over and over and scrapping them. After Faith was recorded, the band went on a huge tour right away. Robert says, I didn't realize what effect it would have on the group. I thought we could just merge the songs in live, and the other songs would balance it out. But it affected everyone. Those songs had a downward spiral on us. The more we played them, the more despondent and desolate we became. Although Faith took its toll on the band at the time, years later, Robert Smith has said in interviews that he loves Faith. And I'd wager to say Lowell and Simon love it too, although you can't quote me on that one. So why did Andy and Pearl land on Bolton Abbey as inspiration for this incredible, beautiful, bleak album? I don't know. Maybe it's because it's been a place of worship since 1154. Maybe it's because in 1539 the Priory was destroyed and looted, left in ruin, only to be revived again years later. And if you look at the cover of Faith, you can barely recognize the Abbey. It's super abstract, but that's why we love it. And whether you're a Cure fan or not, a visit to the Bolton Abbey is highly recommended. Better, better.